Good morning, students. Today I'm going to discuss the one important viscera in our human body, which is called stomach. It is located in between the esophagus proximally and duodenum distally. Now the situation of the stomach within our abdomen is consist of our epigastrium, our left hypochondrium and our umbilical region. So this is the location of the stomach in the normal human body. It is in normal human subject, in living human subject, it is the shape of a J, and the J, it has got different parts. Now it has got two borders, two ends, two orifices, two surface and three subdivisions. Now the two borders are lesser curvature and the greater curvature. Two surface are anterosuperior surface and posteroinferior surface. The two orifices are the cardiac orifice and the pyloric orifice. And three subdivisions, that is called fundus, body and pyloric part. Now, before holding the viscera in normal anatomical position, I will discuss with you different parts of this viscera. Now, the cardiac orifice is this part, which we identify as a less muscular orifice of the stomach. And this orifice is situated approximately 40 centimeter distal from our incisor teeth. In topographical location, it is located 2.5 centimeter left side of the median plane at the level of T11 vertebra behind the 7th costal cartilage. Now this cardiac orifice, and on the anterior surface, it is peritoneal, and the peritoneum of it is the greater sac peritoneum, which will cover the anterior surface. The posterior surface of the cardiac orifice present with a bare area, which is a non-peritoneal area. Now this bare area of the posterior surface of the cardiac end or cardiac orifice will be connected with the left crus of diaphragm by the gastrosplenic ligament. Now the pyloric orifice is this part, this orifice. This distal end of the stomach is called the pyloric orifice, and you can see that this pyloric orifice is much muscular than this cardiac orifice. In cadaveric subjects, sometimes this pyloric orifice will be stained with the bile of the deceased person. Now, by looking at the muscle bulk, we can identify the pyloric end of the stomach. Now, this is topographically located 1.25 centimeter right from the median plane at the level of lower border of the L1 vertebra. And if we pass a horizontal plane through this pyloric end, which will pass on the posterior aspect at the level of lower border of L1 vertebra, and that horizontal plane we call as transpyloric plane. Now this pyloric end will be covered anteriorly by the greater sac peritoneum along with the quadrate lobe of liver and the falciform ligament of the liver. And posteriorly it is related with the neck of the pancreas. Now come to the curve of the stomach. Now I have mentioned that it has got two borders or two curves. One is called lesser curvature, another one is greater. The name suggests the lesser curvature is lesser in length, that is why it is called lesser curvature. Now it is the right border of the stomach. The right border means it starts from the right side of the cardiac orifice and ends at the right side of the pyloric orifice. And this is the shape of a J. Now, in real subject, the stomach is lying almost slightly obliquely. Slightly, the horizontal line is slightly oblique. Now, the lesser curvature is the most dependent part of the lesser curvature is called the incisura angularis, and this is the curve of the J, which is called the incisura angularis, and it is the most dependent part of the stomach. Now, lesser curvature lying on more on the posterior plane than the greater curvature. So, the lesser curvature will be much deeper in location than the greater curvature. Almost, it is 10 cm deeper than from the anterior abdominal plane. Now, the greater curvature, which begins from the left end of the cardiac orifice, forming the cardiac notch, then go upwards and backwards, form up to the left fifth intercostal space, which forms the summit of the greater curvature, and then again goes downwards and curved like this. And thus, this part of the greater curvature which is lying above the cardiac orifice, the horizontal plane passing through the cardiac orifice, is called the fundus of the stomach. Now, after fundus, this greater curvature forms the left border of the body and ends at the pyloric notch. Now, this greater curvature at the level of pyloric notch bulged out downwards, forming this part of the pyloric part, which is called the pyloric antrum. Now, the greater curvature will be covered with or attached with the peritoneum of the greater sac. Now, the surfaces. Surfaces are, I have said that it has got antero superior surface and postero inferior surface, and both the surface are covered with the peritoneum. The antero superior surface will be covered with the greater sac peritoneum. The postero inferior surface will be covered with the lesser sac peritoneum. Now, the antero superior surface comes in relation with the different viscera, and the right part of the anterosuperior surface will lie, the right part of the anterosuperior surface will be covered from above downwards by the left lobe of liver along with the quadrant lobe of liver. The left upper part of the anterosuperior surface will be covered with the diaphragm and the spleen. The inferior part of the anterosuperior surface sometimes comes in relation with the transverse colon when the stomach is empty. Now, the left upper part, along with its relation with the diaphragm and the spleen, it also externally comes in relation with the left pleura, left lung, and the 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th ribs. Now, the area of the stomach on the anterosuperior surface, which comes in direct relation with the anterior abdominal wall, is called the gastric triangle. Now, the triangle is formed on the right side by the inferior border of the liver formed by the left lobe and the quadrant lobe, on the left side by the diaphragm, and in the inferior aspect with the transverse colon. And this triangle is clinically significant because during the obstruction in the esophagus due to esophageal mass, we have to cut here and make an opening for the patient's feeding. Now, the posterior inferior surface comes in relation with the lesser sac peritoneum, and there is a shallow fossa on which the stomach lies, and this fossa is called the stomach bed. Now the posterior inferior surface comes in relation with the different viscera in normal recumbent supine posture. The structures which comes in relation with the posterior inferior surface is the left crus of diaphragm, left suprarenal gland, anterior surface of the left kidney, tortuous splenic artery, anterior surface of the body of the pancreas, transverse mesocolon anterior surface, sometimes the spleen on its lateral border comes in relation with the stomach bed. Now there are three subdivision or three main parts of the stomach, which is called the fundus, body and the pyloric part. Now the fundus consists of the part of the stomach which is lying above the horizontal plane, which will pass through this cardiac end or cardiac notch. So this part is called fundus, which is always occupied with the gaseous distension. Now the summit of it, I have already said that reaches up to the fifth intercostal space near the apex bead. That is why when there is gaseous distension in the fundus, sometimes patient may feel the cardiac distress. Now the part of the stomach below the horizontal plane is called the body, which extends up to the pyloric notch, which is the beginning of the pyloric antrum, and the part of distal to the pyloric notch is the pyloric part, which consists of the pyloric antrum, which is the proximal distended or bulged out, downwards bulged out part of the pyloric end, then pyloric canal, and then pylorus or pyloric orifice. Now the area between the pyloric antrum and the pyloric canal has been demarcated by a sulcus, which is called the sulcus intermedius, which is called the sulcus intermedius, which demarcates the pyloric antrum from the pyloric canal, and the opening is called the pylorus or pyloric orifice. This concludes the different parts of the stomach. I will discuss the next part, or the arteriovenous supply and lymphatic drainage, in my theoretical discussions. Thank you.